Well, some just the latest footage coming to us from Gaza City right now, an Israeli airstrike leveling a 12-story tower. The Associated Press, Al Jazeera, and a number of other news organizations had offices in that building. There were residential units inside as well. The Israeli Defense Forces saying they warned civilians to evacuate the building ahead of the strike. Well, Margaret Evans is on the ground in Jerusalem following all the details for us in this escalating conflict in the Middle East. Margaret, good to see you. You know, this latest airstrike, it comes towards the end of a particularly violent day. What can you tell us?
That's right. It began early in the morning in Gaza with more Israeli airstrikes and artillery fire into the narrow strip. We heard early in the day about the deaths of 10 Palestinians, all members apparently of the same family, most of them children. And as you mentioned, we are also hearing now about this building that was taken out by an airstrike. It housed the Associated Press journalists based in Gaza, as well as Al Jazeera. The Israeli Defense Forces have issued a statement saying that that building was targeted because they knew that Hamas was using what it described as civilian organizations as human shields. The journalists in that building have a different story to tell. There was a statement released today also by the president of the Associated Press. I'll read you a little bit of that. He said the Associated Press is shocked and horrified that the Israeli military would target and destroy the building. He said they knew where the bureaus were. They knew journalists were in there. He said we received a warning that the building would be hit about an hour before it happened. And he also said that the world will know less about what's happening inside the Gaza Strip, inside Gaza, because of what's happened. There have also, of course, been Hamas rockets firing into Israel as well. There were three different alerts in central Israel, and a man was killed in Ramat Gan, that's close to Tel Aviv, from shrapnel when one of those missiles hit. And of course, you have also ongoing violence escalating in the occupied territories. There were demonstrations today to mark what the Palestinians describe as al-Nakba, the catastrophe, dating back to the creation of Israel in 1948, when hundreds of thousands of Palestinians were dispossessed of their lands. This is how the Palestinians view this day in history. It's always been a motive, and there have been demonstrations out in the West Bank today. There were clashes there yesterday as well, and as many as 11 Palestinians dead.
Now, we know that the U.S. envoy is in Israel right now. Talk to us then about negotiations. What's the latest there?
Well, it's still a bit foggy. We did have the arrival yesterday of Hadi Amra, the U.S. envoy. He arrived on a military plane. The White House press secretary said before he left that we wouldn't be seeing a lot of him out in public, that sometimes diplomacy is best conducted in privacy. She did say that they expect that he will consult as widely as possible with leaders in the region because there are fears that this conflict is spreading to Lebanon, to Jordan. He will have a problem when it comes to dealing with the Palestinians. The Palestinians are divided. The president, Mahmoud Abbas, for instance, has no real influence with the militants firing those rockets in the Gaza Strip towards Israel, Hamas, members of the Islamic Jihad. For that, they'll have to rely on Egypt to negotiate. So it's a complicated picture. We also have tomorrow the meeting of the UN Security Council to discuss the crisis.
Margaret, thank you for this. Appreciate it. Our Margaret Evans in Jerusalem.